Hello children, today we will see one important chapter, electric current. All basic concepts I will teach you first, then after we will go in depth. First of all, what is mean by current? Current is a physical quantity which is denoted by I. Current is nothing but the rate of flow of charge by time is called current. The rate of flow of charge is called current. Charge means nothing but charge is flow of electrons. Q is equal plus or minus Ne. E means nothing but electrons. N is nothing but integer. Charge is quantized. Integer means all negative values, positive values you can consider. Suppose what is the charge of 10 electrons? 10 into electron, 1 electron charge 1.602 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb. This is charge of 1 electron. N means integer, Ne means electron. 1 electron charge how much? 1.602 into 10 power minus 19. Charge unit is coulomb. Remember, coulomb. Charge unit is coulomb. Charges are two types. Number one, positive charge. Number two, negative charge. What is mean by positive charge? What is mean by negative charge? Let us consider this is a conductor. Conductor means which allows current freely, which current passes freely. This is A terminal, this is B terminal. Every conductor has two terminals. Where which terminal more number of electrons are present, that is called negative charge. Where less number of electrons are present is called positive charge. How to make one side positive, more number of electrons, how to make less number of electrons on the other side, we will see. Now, once again, current is nothing but rate of flow of charge. Q is nothing but charge by time. Charge unit is coulomb, by time unit second. Coulomb per second is the unit of current. This is formula based unit, but SI unit is ampere. Ampere is a scientist, so write all small letters. Otherwise, only first letter capital A. Whenever scientist name is used as a unit, you have to write all small letters. Otherwise, first letter must be capital. This is ampere. Ampere is the SI unit of current. Current has both magnitude. Magnitude means current is, you can measure 2 ampere, 3 ampere, 5 ampere like this. Current has fixed magnitude. And current has direction. What is the direction of current? Current always flows from higher potential to lower potential. Higher potential means battery positive terminal. Lower potential means battery negative terminal. Current always flows from battery higher potential to lower potential. How current flows also we will see one by one. The bulb glows because of a potential difference. Potential difference is supplied by the battery. Current always flows from battery higher potential to lower potential. That means current has direction. Current has a proper direction. Current has a fixed magnitude. Now tell me, is this physical quantity scalar or vector? Generally, most of the children thought that it has both magnitude and direction. So, current is a vector quantity, but current is not a vector. Current is a scalar. Very important. One more important word also you can say, instead of scalar, you can say tensor quantity. What is mean by tensor? Even though it has both magnitude and direction, current is a scalar quantity, we will see. Let us consider, in this direction 2 ampere current is coming, in this direction 3 ampere current is direction. What is that net flow of current in this wire? 3 plus 2, 5. Sir, 3 plus 2, 5, either it is following loss of vector also, no? Then why can't you say electric current is a vector? Now see, same example I will take. Now these two wires, here 3 ampere current is coming, here 5 ampere current is leaving. Now, what is the net magnitude of current? You cannot say it is a 3 ampere, leaving 5 ampere, it is minus 2 ampere. This is wrong. Why? Because it do not obey vector laws of addition. What is vector law? Vector parallelogram law, we know. If you take a parallelogram, this is a vector, this is A vector, this is B vector, then the magnitude of, then the resultant of this vector is A square plus B square plus 2AB. This theta also we have to consider, 2AB cos theta. If this law do not obey here, hence electric current is a scalar quantity. That means one more important concept you can learn here. To say whether the physical quantity is a vector, we need to understand three things. Number one, it should consist of magnitude, direction, and it should obey vector laws of addition. If these three laws obeys, then only we can say current is a vector quantity. Here third law is not obeying, hence current is a scalar quantity. Once again, I am repeating from starting. Current is denoted by I. Current is rate of flow of charge. Charge by time. Charge is nothing but flow of electrons. Electrons, electron flow. Electrons, where more number of electrons are present is called negative charge. Less number of electrons are present is called positive charge. Charges are two types, positive and negative. Positive charge, if two charges are present, then only current flows. Charge SI unit is ampere. Ampere is denoted by capital A. And charge formula plus or minus Ne, where N is integer, E is electron. Charge of one electron is 1.602 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb. Even though current has both magnitude and direction, current is a scalar quantity because it do not obey vector laws of addition. Remember up to here, one more important point, here to measure the current, we have two instruments. Those two instruments are ammeter and galvanometer. Here we will see. To measure the current, we have two instruments. One is ammeter, one is galvanometer. Ammeter measures current, galvanometer also measures current. Then what is the use of two instruments to measure one physical quantity? There is a small difference. Ammeter measures current in amperes, whereas galvanometer measures current in milliamperes. Small amount of current, lemon produce some amount of current, dung produce some amount of current, decomposed vegetables produce some amount of current. All these currents can be measured. Very small magnitude of current can be measured with galvanometer. More amperes of current is measured with ammeter. These two must be connected in series. What is mean by series, we will see later. Remember up to here. Current is denoted by I. Current is rate of flow of charge. Current is a scalar quantity. Unit SI unit of current is ampere. To flow the current, we need two charges, positive and negative. Positive charge is nothing but at which terminal more number of electrons are present. Positive charge means where less number of electrons are present. Negative charge means at which terminal more number of electrons are present. Charge unit is coulomb. What is the unit of charge? Charge unit is coulomb. Charge is a fundamental physical quantity like mass. Without charge, there is no current. For the flow of current, how many charges are required? Two charges are required, positive and negative. Next topic we will see, these are all important terminology. Next, potential, also called voltage, denoted by V. What is meant by potential? Before going to learn potential, you need a simple circuit. This is what consumer may be bulb, fan, fridge, whatever it is, which consumes voltage is called consumer. This is a bulb. These two terminals of the bulb I connected to a battery. This is a plug key. Plug key is used to allow or stop the current. If you plus the key, the current flows. If you remove the key, current do not flow. This is battery positive terminal. This is negative terminal. Already I told you, current always flows from higher potential to lower potential. Battery positive terminal to negative terminal. Now, no doubt the bulb glows. The bulb is glowing. Why the bulb is glowing? Because here the battery is doing some work. What type of work? what if some kind of chemical work it is doing, the working that we will see in working of battery. Here the battery is doing some work. What type of work it is doing? It is making one unit positive charge to bring from one point to the consumer. It is there somewhere else inside the battery. Some one unit positive charge it is bringing from infinity to the consumer. This is called potential definition. Once again, the work done by the cell to bring one unit positive charge from infinity to the consumer. Once again, I'm repeating. The battery is doing some chemical work. What kind of chemical work it is doing? It is making to bring one unit positive charge from infinity to the consumer is called nothing but potential. You cannot measure potential. Remember, very, very important. Potential you cannot measure. Only we can measure potential difference. The difference between here and here, these two terminals, potential difference we can measure. Potential difference is measured with the help of voltmeter. Directly you can connect voltmeter in between these two terminals also. Voltmeter is an instrument used to measure the potential difference. Potential difference has no definition. There is potential difference only. We will modify it into potential difference. What is potential? The work done by the cell to bring one unit positive charge from infinite. It is there somewhere else. We cannot measure. Somewhere else inside the battery. The chemical is providing positive charge. The work done by the cell to bring one unit positive charge from infinite to the consumer is called potential. Potential unit is volt. It is measured. Potential difference is measured with a voltmeter. Voltmeter is an instrument used to measure the potential difference. Voltmeter is always connected in parallel. Remember, it should be connected in parallel. Parallel means between two terminals, between two ends of the consumer. This is what potential difference. Very, very important. Once again, potential. Potential means the work done by the chemical force to bring one unit positive charge from infinite to the consumer is called potential. From infinite to consumer, it brings one unit positive charge is called potential. Potential is work by charge, work by unit positive charge, W by Q. So that you can also say the work done by the battery V is equal V into plus Q or VQ. W is equal V into Q. V is nothing but potential of the battery and Q is one unit positive charge. If you multiply these two, you will get work done by the cell. If more number of positive charge brings from one point to another point, then work done by the battery also more. To measure the potential difference, we use voltmeter. Voltmeter must be connected in parallel. Remember, there is no current without voltage. Very, very important. There is no current without voltage. Current and the relation between current and voltage was given by Siemens Ohm. That we will see in Ohm's law. Next, we will see Ohm's law. Before going to Ohm's law, we need to understand one more important physical quantity. That is what resistance. Here, remember, this is a bulb filament. This bulb filament is made up of tungsten. The Latin name is wolfram. We know wolfram is nothing but tungsten. Tungsten Latin name is wolfram. Why we are using only tungsten as a filament bulb? Why can't copper? Why can't another metal, silver? Why can't gold? Why? Because tungsten melting point is very high. Melting point of tungsten is 3422 degrees centigrade. It can bear high temperature, so that even though the filament heats up, it do not break, it do not melt. High temperatures can bear by the tungsten filament. Hence we are using tungsten filament as a tungsten material as a filament of the bulb. What is the melting point of the tungsten filament? 3422 degrees centigrade, very, very high. So that the lifespan of the bulb is very high. What is the function of this tungsten filament? It is obstructing the flow of electrons. What it is doing? Obstructing the flow of electrons. Whenever charges are coming from the battery, charge is nothing but flow of electrons. These electrons are opposed by the tungsten filament. Whenever electrons are opposed by the tungsten filament, what will happen? It turns into heat energy. Whenever more number of electrons are opposed by the conductor, what will happen? The heat energy increases. That heat energy converts into light energy because it is completely filled with inert gases. So that chemical energy is converting into heat energy. Heat energy is converting into light energy so that the bulb glows. This property is called nothing but resistance of the bulb. This resistance of the filament. This is resistance means the obstructing of free flow of electrons is called resistance. Resistance is denoted by R. Symbol of resistance is this one, saw blade. Unit of resistance is ohm. Why? Because the resistance term is used by ohm. The definition of resistance is also given by Siemens ohm. Hence, resistance unit is ohm. Resistance means the obstructing of free flow of electrons is called resistance. Resistance, this is a symbol, this is what unit. Resistance is denoted by R. SI unit of resistance is ohm. Once again, from starting onwards, I will revise once. Potential, also called voltage. Potential we cannot measure. We can measure only potential difference. Potential is denoted by V. The work done by the cell to bring one unit positive charge from infinite to the consumer is called potential. Unit of potential is volt. To measure the potential difference, we use potential difference. Potential difference only we will measure. To measure the potential difference, we use voltmeter. Voltmeter is an instrument used to measure the PD between any consumer, any electric consumer. Voltmeter must be always connected in parallel. Parallel means between two ends. Then only we can measure potential difference. The work done, the potential formula is W by plus Q. W, from this W is equal to V into Q. V is potential into charge. Potential difference has no particular definition. Potential difference means, let us consider here potential is 5 volt, here potential is 3 volt. The difference will be here 5 volt, here 3 volt. The difference will be 2 volt. The only we can measure the potential difference, but potential means work done by the cell to bring one unit positive charge from infinite to consumer. These three definitions we will see once again, then after we will go to Ohm's law. See children, tell me what is mean by current. What is the definition of current? Current is equal to nothing but rate of flow of charge. Current unit, SI unit is ampere. To measure the current, we have two instruments. One is ammeter, one is galvanometer. These two must be connected in series. Charge. Charge is nothing but Q. Charge is nothing but plus or minus Ne, number of electrons. Where N is integer, Q is charge. Charge of one electron is 1.602 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb. N is integer. Integer may be negative values, 0 or positive values, anyone you can take. Charge is quantized. Without charge, there is no current. Charges are two types. One is positive charge, one is negative charge. Positive charge means in a conductor where less number of electrons are present. Negative charge means where more number of electrons are present. This is what charge. Next, voltage or potential. Voltage is denoted by V, also called potential. The work done by the cell to bring one unit positive charge from one point to another point are infinite to the consumer. The work done by the cell to bring one unit positive charge from infinite to the consumer is called voltage. Voltage we cannot measure. We can measure only voltage potential difference. This is also called potential. Potential we cannot measure. Potential difference we can measure. We can measure with the help of voltmeter. Voltmeter must be connected in parallel. Voltmeter must be always connected in parallel. Next one, resistance. Resistance is denoted by R. Resistance is equal to V is equal to IR. From this R is equal to V by I according to Ohm's law. That we will see now. Resistance unit is ohm. To measure the resistance, we have one instrument is called ohmmeter. Ohmmeter is an instrument used to measure the resistance. It is also connected in series. Except voltmeter, remaining all must be connected in series only. Only voltmeter is connected in parallel. Resistance R, unit ohm. Resistance to find the R, the formula is voltage by current. It is measured with ohmmeter. Ohmmeter also connected in series. Unit of resistance is ohm. Symbol of resistance is saw blade, like saw blade. This is what a symbol of resistance. Any doubt, children? Current, క్యూబైటి కరెంట్ యూనిట్ ఆంపియర్, ఇన్స్ట్రుమెంట్స్ అమ్మీటర్ అండ్ గ్యాలోనోమీటర్. అమ్మీటర్ మెజర్స్ కరెంట్ ఇన్ ఆంపియర్స్, వేరస్ గ్యాలోనోమీటర్ మెజర్స్ ఇన్ మిల్లీ ఆంపియర్. ఛార్జ్ క్యూ, ఛార్జ్ ఈజ్ క్వాంటైజ్డ్, క్వాంటైజ్డ్ మీన్స్ మల్టిప్లైడ్ బై ఎనీ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్. ఛార్జెస్ ఆర్ టూ టైప్స్, పాజిటివ్ అండ్ నెగటివ్. వేర్ ఇన్ ఏ కండక్టర్ వేర్ లెస్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఆర్ ప్రజెంట్ ఈజ్ కాల్డ్ పాజిటివ్ ఛార్జ్, వేర్ మోర్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఆర్ ప్రజెంట్ ఈజ్ కాల్డ్ నెగటివ్ ఛార్జ్. ఛార్జ్ ఎస్ఐ యూనిట్ ఈజ్ కూలుమ్, ఛార్జ్ యూనిట్ ఈజ్ కూలుమ్, రిమెంబర్ ఛార్జ్ యూనిట్ ఈజ్ కూలుమ్. సో దట్ కరెంట్ యూనిట్ యూ కెన్ రైట్ ఇట్ యాజ్ కూలుమ్ పర్ సెకండ్ ఆల్సో, బట్ ఎస్ఐ యూనిట్ ఈజ్ ఆంపియర్. ఛార్జ్ ఎస్ ప్లస్ ఆర్ మైనస్ ఎన్ఈ, వేర్ ఎన్ ఈజ్ ఇంటీజర్, క్యూ ఈజ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ ఛార్జ్. వన్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ ఛార్జ్ ఈజ్ 1.602 × 10⁻¹⁹ కూలుమ్. నెక్స్ట్ పొటెన్షియల్, పొటెన్షియల్ మీన్స్ ద వర్క్ డన్ బై ద సెల్ టు బ్రింగ్ వన్ యూనిట్ పాజిటివ్ ఛార్జ్ ఫ్రమ్ ఇన్ఫైనైట్ టు ద కన్స్యూమర్. పొటెన్షియల్ వీ కెనాట్ మెజర్ ఆర్ వోల్టేజ్ వీ కెనాట్ మెజర్, వీ కెన్ మెజర్ ఓన్లీ పొటెన్షియల్ డిఫరెన్స్. పొటెన్షియల్ డిఫరెన్స్ ఈజ్ మెజర్డ్ విత్ వోల్టమీటర్, వోల్టమీటర్ మస్ట్ బి కనెక్టెడ్ ఇన్ ప్యారలల్ టు ఫైండ్ ద పొటెన్షియల్. ద ఫార్ములా ఈజ్ వర్క్ డన్ బై ద సెల్ బై ఛార్జ్ క్యూ. నెక్స్ట్ రెసిస్టెన్స్, రెసిస్టెన్స్ ఈజ్ ఆర్ ద అపోజిషన్ ఆఫ్ ఫ్రీ ఫ్లో ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఆర్ ద అబ్స్ట్రక్షన్ ఆఫ్ ఫ్రీ ఫ్లో ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఈజ్ కాల్డ్ రెసిస్టెన్స్. రెసిస్టెన్స్ ఆర్ ఈజ్ కాల్డ్ V/I. యూనిట్ ఈజ్ ఓమ్. ఓమ్ మీటర్ ఈజ్ అన్ ఇన్స్ట్రుమెంట్ యూజ్ టు మెజర్ ద రెసిస్టెన్స్. దిస్ ఇస్ ద సింబల్ ఆఫ్ రెసిస్టెన్స్. అండర్స్టాండ్? నో డౌట్, కాపీ ఇట్. రైట్, నౌ యూ హ్యావ్ వన్ డౌట్ సార్, హౌ టు మేక్ ద సర్క్యూట్ టు మెజర్ దీస్ మెనీ ఇన్స్ట్రుమెంట్స్, కనెక్టింగ్ దీస్ మెనీ ఇన్స్ట్రుమెంట్స్ ఆర్ వెరీ వెరీ డిఫికల్ట్ నో? ఎస్, వెరీ డిఫికల్ట్. సో దట్ వన్ మోర్ ఇన్స్ట్రుమెంట్ ఈజ్ డెవలప్డ్ బై సైంటిస్ట్, దట్ ఈజ్ కాల్డ్ మల్టీమీటర్. వాట్ ఈస్ దట్? మల్టీమీటర్. దట్ ద ఇన్స్ట్రుమెంట్స్ నేమ్ ఇట్ సెల్ఫ్ ఈజ్ సేయింగ్ మల్టీమీటర్ మెజర్స్ మల్టిపుల్ ఫిజికల్ క్వాంటిటీస్. లైక్ దిస్ ఈజ్ ఎ మల్టీమీటర్. This multimeter, this is what display, this is what selection knob. Now these are two ports, these are the main parts. This is what display, this is what selection knob. These are called ports. One by one we will see. Display can display all including of integers 0, 1 like this. All numbers it can display, positive, negative, zero, everything, decimals and all. Display is used to measure the most accurate number in the form of decimal, in the form of a fraction, whatever it is, every number can be displayed on the display. Selection knob is used to select the desired instrument. This multimeter measure, multimeter acts as a meter, it acts as a galvanometer, it acts as a voltmeter. It acts as a ohm meter. These mean instruments we can measure at a time. At a time we can measure current in amperes, current in milliamperes, potential difference in volts and resistance in ohms. All these physical quantities we can measure with a single instrument. That is why this is called multimeter. Multimeter consists of mainly three parts. Number one, display, selection knob and ports. Display is used to select the desired number on the display. Selection knob is used to select the desired instrument. If you select the arrow mark on the ammeter, it acts as ammeter. If it selects on the arrow mark, if you place on milliampere, it acts as a galvanometer. If it is placed on V, it acts as a voltmeter. If it is placed on ohmmeter, it acts as a resistance ohmmeter. Like this, wherever you want, you can measure the instrument based on arrow mark placed. If you place arrow mark placed at different places, it acts as ammeter, galvanometer, voltmeter, ohmmeter. Ports. These are two types of ports are present in this instrument. One is black color, one is red color. One is called COM, common port. We call it as COM, common port. Another port is MAV omega. M means milliampere, ampere, voltage and ohm, resistance. That means it acts as a galvanometer, it acts as ammeter, it acts as a voltmeter, it acts as a ohm, voltmeter, and last it acts as a ohmmeter. Four instruments we can see in a single instrument. This is the use of multimeter. Once again I'll tell you, multimeter is used to measure current, voltage and resistance at a time. It can measure current in amperes, milliamperes, voltage in potential difference in volts and resistance in ohms. All these four physical quantities at a time we can measure with this single instrument. Now, this multimeter consists of mainly three parts. Number one, display, selection knob and ports. Ports, P-O-R-T-S, ports. Display can display not only integers, not only negative values, positive values and zero. It can show decimals also, 0.0001. Most accurate values it can display on the display board. Selection knob. The arrow mark of the selection knob, if you place an ammeter, it acts as ammeter. If you place arrow mark on MA, it acts as a galvanometer. If arrow mark is on V, it acts as a voltmeter. If arrow mark is on ohm meter, it acts as a resistance. It measures resistance. So, last one, ports. Two types of ports are present. One is a common port, one is MAV omega. Common port, you have to fix this one black color wire, one red color wire. Generally, we could see in watch repairing centers, telephone repairing centers, next TV repairing centers. So many, in all electronic shops, we will see this multimeter. So that the common port, one fixed port will be present. We will not disturb it. But a red color wire, one more wire will be present, that is called MAV omega, that we will measure, that based on that wire we can measure different physical quantities. This is about a multimeter. Understand, friends? Right. Next, one more important topic, loss of resistance. Loss of resistance. Or what are the factors affecting on resistance? Factors or loss, both are same. Factors affecting on resistance or loss of resistance. Remember, very important, resistance is denoted by R. Resistance unit is ohm. This is the symbol of resistance. Resistance depends on four factors. Resistance depends on four factors. Number one. Nature of material. If material changes, resistance also changes. Resistance depends on four factors. Number one, nature of material. Number two, temperature. Number three, length. Number four, area of cross section. Area of cross section means thickness. These are the four factors which is influenced by the resistance. Nature of the material, one small activity we will see. These are two terminals. This is what battery, plug key, this is ammeter. Now, in between these two terminals, this is A, B. In between these two terminals, I connected one voltmeter. This is battery, positive terminal, negative terminal, plug key. Battery provides potential difference. The use of batteries to provide potential difference, plug key, to allow or stop the current. If you switch the plug, current flows. If you remove the key, current do not flow. Ammeter to measure the current, it measures the current. Voltmeter is used to measure the potential difference. Now, this is the direction of current, higher potential to lower potential. Now, I have different instruments. Number one, copper wire, 10 cm length, 1 mm square thickness. This is thickness, this is length. I have silver wire, AG, argentinum, silver wire, manganese wire, and gold wire, RM. All length and thickness is same. These three different wires I placed in between A and B terminals. I placed copper wire one time, silver wire one time, and manganese wire one time, gold wire one time. Each and every time I noted down voltmeter reading and ammeter reading, and I find the ratio of V by I. This is what nothing but resistance. You can observe that this resistance value varies if material changes. If material changes, R value also changes. That means R depends on nature of material. R depends on nature. First one is proved. Number two, temperature. Now, here you connect one bulb. Remove the key and note down. Whenever current do not flow, note down voltmeter reading and ammeter reading. Find V by I ratio. V by I is nothing but R. If you find V by I ratio, you will get one value. Let it be 10 ohm. Now switch off the key. Whenever current flows, the bulb glows. Whenever the bulb glows, again measure V by I ratio. That means now let it be, this is 40 ohm. That means if temperature increases, V by I ratio also increasing. That means resistance depends on temperature. If temperature increases, resistance also increases, no doubt. Length increases. Instead of 10 cm, if you take 20 cm, then also what will happen? V by I ratio increases. That means resistance is directly proportional to length. Resistance is directly proportional to temperature. Resistance is resistance depends on nature of material. Last one, thickness. Suppose a person is very fat, his resistance is very less. Here also, instead of 1 millimeter square, if you take 5 millimeter square, if these three materials, if you place in between them, what will happen? Thickness increases, V by ratio decreases. That means, if you are very fat, your resistance will be less. Like that, resistance is inversely proportional to area of cross section. Very, very important. Remember, resistance depends on 4 factors. Number 1, nature of material. Number 2, temperature. Number 3, length of the conductor. Number 4, area of the cross section. If material is different, resistance also will be varies. Temperature increases, resistance also increases. In open circuit, the resistance will be different. In closed circuit, if the current flows automatically, the bulb, the resistance also increases. So that the temperature varies, resistance also varies. Length increases, resistance also increases. Area of cross section, thickness increases, resistance decreases. Remember these three. From this loss of resistance, we will define one important definition. See here, resistance is directly proportional to length and inversely proportional to area. If you remove proportional to one constant is required, that constant is nothing but rho L by A. This rho is called nothing but resistivity. This is called resistivity, also called specific resistance. Resistance. Now define what is specific resistance. Cross multiply, what will happen? Ra by L. Suppose this is the conductor. Length is fixed 1 meter. Let us consider length is 1 meter. Area of cross section thickness is 1 millimeter square. If length and area of cross section of different materials are fixed, copper, silver, aluminium, different wires, fixed length and fixed thickness. If you take fixed length and fixed area, then the resistance of this material is called nothing but resistivity. Very, very important resistivity. If any conductor length is fixed, whatever the conductor you take, you can take manganese wire, copper wire, silver wire, gold wire, length is fixed 1 meter, thickness is 1 millimeter square. Let us consider. If you take fixed length and fixed thickness, then that resistance of the material is called, if these two are fixed, then the resistance of the material is called resistivity. Resistivity is not a definition, it is a numerical value. To find resistivity, the formula is Ra by L. Unit of resistance is ohm. Area means length into breadth, meter into meter, by one length meter, meter, meter cancel. Ohm into meter is the unit of specific resistance. Unit of specific resistance is ohm into meter. Very important. Specific resistance or resistivity unit is ohm into meter. Specific resistance depends on only two factors. Why? Because specific resistance depends on only two factors. Length and area, these two are fixed. Length is fixed, area is fixed. So it depends only on two factors. What are they? Number one, nature of the material. Number two, temperature. Only resistivity depends on two factors. Resistance depends on four factors. Resistivity depends on only two factors. This is nature of material, temperature, length, area. But these two are fixed here. Only it depends on nature of the material and temperature. Understand? Right. Remember up to here. Remaining we will see in the next video. All the best.